Hey, hello, and welcome back. Last week I had the video about riding RD6018, and at the moment it was the heaviest version available. And I did buy it in a kit, but not in a complete kit because the kit usually does have, of course, the front, the casing. This is the S800, but usually you get the 800 watts power supply. And that was a bit silly to me, so I ordered it as a package but without the power supply. And I ordered one power supply from Lincoya, 1200 watts. That should be efficient because this is 60 volt, 18 amps, and the 800 watts, of course, is a lot less because you should have 1080 if you add that together. So I thought 1200 is good, and it is great, and we had fun building it. And I even managed to load in the logo, so I have a custom logo if I switch it on. But there is one thing. It is super, super, super noisy. So that's why these ones. And I want to change it because it is very uncomfortable having these on your head in the lab. So I thought of a solution. I have a few. This is a normal thermostatic switch. You can adjust them. I think there's $2, and it's the W1209. I did a review of this one before. I switch it off. I did a review about this before, but yeah, it only switches on and off, and you have a normally open contact and a normally closed, but that means it's completely silent until it gets hot or 40 degrees or what temperature that you set, and then it goes full power. So, and it's quite a bit of electronics just to control the fan, but the casing is big enough, so I wouldn't worry about that. Also, then there is an even cheaper solutions. I think these are 50 cents. It's also a thermic switch, and you can buy different temperatures. Also 40 degrees, 50 degrees, 90 degrees. I think those three I have, and some are normally open, some are normally closed. So if you buy them normally open, it just goes at a certain point at the correct temperature, and then it is closed, and then your fan will run. So, but then again, it's also on and off, on and off. These are cool. And yeah, maybe you can even use one of these if you have the normally closed and you're using for 90 degrees, that you use it as a protection. That's very good for this. But then you need to put them in the line. And so when the heating element or the so when the heat sink then reaches 90 degrees, then you can switch off the line. It can do about 1 amp. So, but yeah, it's for protection. It's nice. Maybe I do that in my electronic load, the one that I built myself. But better would be for this, and that's what I'm going to do today. It's a PWM controller, and I think these are also 1.5 for $2. And you put this in between of your fan, and it has a temperature sensor. And you have them for 5 volt and 12 volt. This one is 12. I bought it two different versions. No, actually it was the same version, but two different stores, AliExpress and in the Banggood. I will leave the links also below. Comes with a nice cable, so you just take out your fan, put in this one, this module, and the fan you put again in here. It has a little temperature sensor. You just they even edit here a little clamp so you can screw it somewhere stuck. So that is completely only the manual is drama. It is partly Chinese, partly English, and some people already collected from other manuals. Well, and from those manuals I again also created one, so hopefully then we have all the facts, and I put it also in the links. So let's start. Oh, I forgot to tell you. Why do you want this PWM module? PWM is pulse width modulation, and So instead of putting 12 volt, it put little blocks of 12 volt, and you can make the spacing bigger or smaller. And when you have a smaller pulse, then well, effectively you have a lower voltage. Okay, let's open it. I didn't check in the power supply itself, the switch power unit. If there is enough space, maybe we need to drill extra holes. I really didn't look into that. But yeah, usually you should find a spot somewhere where you can drill a hole. And maybe even, because when you start drilling holes in the power supply, then maybe you get the EMI issues. So, but there is another casing around it, so that should not be a problem. But yeah, maybe we can check that also. I have those probes, never tried those before, and I still have a few hours on my spectrum analyzer of the EMI software, so maybe I can use that, and then I can find the best spot where to drill the hole. That is the idea. But maybe I should not worry about it, and then I just put some metal tape around the hole, and then it's also closed. But yeah, we see. Okay, casing is open. I put that down. And yeah, I did put the temperature sensor here. But I understood later that this is if you want to charge batteries with a special battery function in the front. With this kind of silly thing. So this is absolutely not needed. But here we have the Lincoya power supply, and it's huge. And yeah, let's find out. And there is another thing I didn't. I thought about it in the night later. That is, usually they say some power supplies have a minimum current before they are stable or before they can start up. And in this one, it was not in the specification what was the minimum current that it needs to switch on and be stable. So maybe they didn't mention it because the newer ones don't necessarily have that, or they have an internal resistor. But I was thinking later, maybe they do this because the modern ones need only 100 milliamps or less. Maybe that's why they put the fan in full power, because then you also have your load. So if I then put this PWM controller, maybe then I need to start thinking of having this load resistor, because then there is no load when the fan is not spinning. So that was just something I was thinking about. Yeah, I just completely need to remove the power supply to have a better look where all the screws are. And then we can have a good look inside. But it's a bit of a pity because all the wires are really connected really, really nicely. All have the correct length. But this plug I can unplug, and then maybe I can just move it to the side. So I will be removing the screws here from the bottom. And yeah, I come back. Okay, I untie all the screws, so now I can just, I should be able to take it out, yes. And when I just pull this plug, yeah, maybe I don't see too many screws, to be honest. There's one in the back here. Oh, there is a huge hole here. That's where we can take out the cables, so I don't need to drill. So then we don't make any changes. I think I just remove the line also. Because then I can just have good access. So there is a seal here, that one is probably going, and the only screws I see are here in the back, and it's really very thin metal. here is one, and here is one, and then we can just slide it out. I think we need to be careful because it's a switch mode power supply. Usually there are caps in the line, so it could be like 400 volts or more. We'll just cut the seal, it doesn't matter. Okay. Okay, there's a big hole here, so we can take the wires out then. We need to be careful with the caps. And where is the real heat produced? Because that can be here, but I also see a very big there. Yeah, but here are a lot of them. Here I see only two. So that's why I also want to leave it running the ventilator, but not on full power. So at least this is cool. And yeah, this seems to be separate. I'm not so sure which one produces the most heat. Probably this one, this is the biggest heat sink. Yeah, there are only two. Yeah, it's here. So I will put the temperature sensor on this one. Okay, I was looking for the voltage of and the current of the ventilator. But it turns out it is not 12. And it's not 5. It is 24. I will make a picture of that later. So that is a bit of a pity because this module is for 12. So it will never spin fast enough. So then I think the most convenient solution, the most easy solution, will then indeed be the on and off. Okay, well, I don't need to be worried too much about the load resistor. Because what I see right here is that I already put a load resistor, so that's very convenient. Thank you, Linkoya. And also here in the back, also to start a little circuit. So that is already done. Yes. Okay, if I want to make it with the PWM module, I need to replace the ventilator with the 12 volt ventilator because I couldn't find any PWM controllers for 24 volts. Well, they were there, but not temperature controlled. So I think I just go with the simple and set this to 40 degrees and then it switches on and off. So I will just be taking the ventilator out and there was a little hole here. Get the wires out there. I can turn the fan so we have a little bit more power cord. Yeah, there is a space. Okay. And this one I will just connect like this. Like this, and then we go out here, and then we have our 20 volts here. We make the 12 volts go to the temperature controller right here. Oh, there is already a power regulator there. Like this, then the fan there, temperature controller to the inside, done. Okay, because I'm going for the simple controller, it's nice to set the temperature, but I will not do the fan off and on, but I will do the fan like half speed and full power. And I will do that by putting a resistor on the contact. I turn 180 degrees, so I have a longer wire now. So this can go here. This is the 24 volts that I need to regulate down to 12 to go into this module. And well, it will fit if I do that here. The temperature controller is going on this one, because this is in the flow and it's also connected already to the casing. So this will cool enough when the fan is doing all speed. And this one, I will put this sensor. And I've here the sensor from the board. I can also do that from this side. And I will just put that with tape, because the ribs are not big enough to put it in between. But if I use this metal tape that I use for heaters, that this stuff, it is heat resistant but also heat conductive. So that will probably work very well. I just take off a little bit. And also on top of that, heat goes up. You need to be careful, this is conductive. We're not gonna touch it when it's switched on. So I will just, yes, it looks ugly, but I think it is very, very, very effective. This is proper. Cut it off. Like this. Okay, this is stuck. This will transfer heat. This goes also to this module, so I can just close it and then we can work safe. Okay, because it was all 24 volts, I just used my normal thermic switch instead of the PWM controller, because that was just not possible. This is the 24 volts of the ventilator that comes out of the power supply, and one of the lines goes to a buck converter. I set that to about 9 volts, just low speed that you don't hear it, and then the fan in normal it will go slow speed and you don't hear it. Then I have here also a little regulator for my temperature controller, because that one needs 12 volts. And in this temperature controller, it will just switch on a certain temperature I set, and then it will switch the full power to the ventilator. So it is sort of on-off, only there is now, because of this little buck converter, it is low speed until it gets hot, and then it switches to full 24 volts. And how does that look in practice? Okay, this is what it looks in practice. We have here the temperature sensor. Here is the 24 volts in. And if you can see underneath here is my 12 volt, but the 12 volt here only goes to the temperature controller. And it goes through. And here I have another one that is the 24 volts, goes through a diode, and then it switches full power to the ventilator. Here we have another 24 volts, goes through the buck converter, and then through a diode, and it also goes to the ventilator. I put two diodes because I'm not sure, the relay probably doesn't mind to, if you put signal back in, the 9 volts, that would not have been a problem. But I don't think the buck converter likes if you put on the output, so I just wanted to be sure I put the two diodes there. Like this, it doesn't fit in the box, but then I can just flip this over. And the 9 volts, I can just adjust here until the lowest speed is not noticeable. And then here you set the temperature. Well, these temperature switches are actually quite nice. It is the W1209. I did do a review about it. You just set the temperature, push it, it starts blinking. I set it now to 29, but I can set it a little bit higher. But this is maybe nice for the test. So you set it, and you set the temperature that you want. If I set it now to 26, I set it to 25, then it will probably switch on. And there it is, and there is the noise. And you see the red LED that it is switched on. I set it back to 29 or 30. And the noise is off. And the low speed is on. I will get my microphone closer so you can hear the low speed. And I can show you how to adjust it. Okay, I will get my ear close. Now it is very low. I think it is almost not noticeable that I can make the speed a little bit higher. Then you start to hear it, but I will put it back. And in my test, because now I'm also printing in the back with my laser, so it is a bit noisy, so I cannot really hear, but in my test it was, when it was silent, and also I opened the windows, I have some outside noise, but if I was around 9 volts, then the sound was low, and we still had a little bit of airflow. Yeah, now it, I'm measuring on the diode, so I need a little bit more. I will do, well, it's 0.7 probably, so I will do. This Owen is a bit slow, it's not that nice to adjust. Okay, so now it's probably 9. Yeah. Okay, and the noise is almost not noticeable, and I still can feel that it's running. So then until it goes to 30 degrees, and then it will get full power. So here it is, it's finished. Nice with the logo. And no noise, that is really great. And yeah, it's a pity about the 24 volts. I could also have solved it differently with the with the 12 volt PWM controller, and it's changing the fan to 12 volts. And but I didn't have that fan size, so I just decided to continue the project with yeah, like this. Just put it with tape, so it is stuck. But it is indeed not my best project, but it fits exactly in the box if you look at it like this. The height will do exactly, so no problems there. But yeah, it's all with tape. But I just wanted to use the power supply without being in the noise, and then later I designed something proper. So that's it, not my best mod. I can put these ones back again in the garage, so I need no, I don't need those again. And now there is a little bit of noise, and that is just because I set it to 29, and it is kind of hot now. But wait, it will switch off. It will just cool down because of the ventilator. I think you can hear now. This is loud. And there it shuts down until it heats up again. Perfect. And now it's in super low speed. Silent. So that's it. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.